All right, hello everyone, and welcome back to the last series of the day for Mr. Cat. We are at the lower bracket finals. Winner of this best of three, moving on to the grand finals happening tomorrow morning, where your Mr. Cat Season 2 victor will be crowned. But for now, we gotta figure out who's gonna get there. Warriors Gaming coming off a successful series up against Geek Fam, able to take that 1-2-1, and now they're immediately put back to the test up against the winner's bracket finals, or winner's bracket runner-up, Clutch Gamers, who dropped down yesterday. I got him, man. I cleaned it up, man. I'm Android, being joined by Trent.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Mr. Trent. Cat, for those who've stuck around, and welcome to our newer viewers. Probably some of you EU folks, maybe getting rolling out of bed a little bit late, lazy Saturday morning. I understand. It's okay. It's like 1 or 2, you know, 3 o'clock maybe, depending on where you are.
Is it Saturday? But
it's time. It is. I know. I also lose the days of the week. Who actually cares anymore, right? Those things.
I haven't slept in like 48 hours.
Exactly. That's the spirit.
Whew. All right. Warriors Gaming Unity. They looked really strong in series number one. Game one, Geek Fam. They just got the better of certain rotations and initiations. But I mean, for the most part, Warriors are really good at finding that early momentum, you know, rotating where they need to rotate, getting their big boys started off to a good start. And we'll see if Clutch is going to be able to stop that. This time, Clutch snapping up the Slardar for themselves. Definitely a high priority pick. Snapping up the Disruptor, too. So some repeat performances. Our Centaur Warrunner comes back in. Excited for that one.
Yeah, a little interesting scene to get first pick overall this time. Of course, we've seen them with the either the Earth Spirit and Slardar, or Slardar, that is, in all three games today for Warriors Gaming. So no immediate go into the most important position for Roamers. And I think CG probably knew this was going to happen, I would guess, by the fact they banned the Earth Spirit and then the Ogre. So they knew that Warriors Game would either pick the Centaur or the Slardar, and they would get the other. And this limits those roaming possibilities from WG. Even the Sven's actually kind of smart ban, too, because it's not only that Warcry for, you know, as a position one, but you can also run position four Sven pretty successfully against minus armor strats. And the position four pool, once again, is getting lower and lower. I mean, even Weaver is gone now, who we'll see there sometimes, too.
Damn, Weaver banned out. That's, I guess Clutch like their Weaver.
Yeah, very strong hero right now, too, of course. Egg has banned first phase all three of our first games this morning, so we won't be finding him here today. We do have the Boombox hero already decided. We have Disruptor, we have our Slardar. So obviously either going to be the four or possibly the three there for Rappy. Tagged up as Hannah. That guy played exceptionally well so far in this tournament. They didn't have any luck against Faceless, obviously, as they went down 2-0. But CG certainly looking to go into the right back into that final. Head right back on up to face up against Faceless tomorrow.
Yeah, Faceless are going to be the other team that one of these bad boys
10 seconds
will have to fight against. And Faceless kind of just made a clean sweep through Mr. Cat.
5 seconds remaining.
They looked really strong the whole way through. So, going to be difficult, but Clutch Gamers, I think they're up for the challenge. And Warriors Gaming showing they have got so much fight inside.
Luna
picked up now. We're going for the purple-blue strat on Radiant side. But what's going to pair with this Luna? Obviously, we have Disruptor already picked up. How do you get the most out of the Cat Lady?
There's a potential setup, I suppose, right? If you really want to go back for the Shao Demon. We don't actually see SC Luna too much, but Rappy could just hop onto the Slardar. This could be one of those times where it's more beneficial to do that. But there's still a decent offlaner pool left. We've only lost the Darkseer and the Centaur, so not too big of a deal. We can just move into some of those other heroes, perhaps your Legion Commanders, maybe opting in towards what else we have left. Yeah, geez, they played a lot of Centaur lately for themselves too. I guess we still have like Axe Timber, those kind of heroes there for Rappy. So we'll have to find out exactly what they want to do with their Luna. I think they were kind of forcing their picking their one here, I would say. I don't think you want to give away where the Slardar is going to go or necessarily decide for yourself where he'll be either. And an OD choice here, almost as much of a deny pick as it is a pick for themselves here.
I think it's one of those like, oh shit, OD's still in the pool. get him. Usually doesn't make it past that second round of bans. So Warriors Gaming, maybe not the most synergistic hero, but what they got so far, but they can certainly make it worth. He dishes out so much damage.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, he works very well for the Roamer too, because they don't have their position four available for WG, and we talk about how a lot of them banned out. Now with the setup from an OD, you can move into something like even a Nyx Assassin or something. Position four can work if it ends up countering something that clutch gamers go for. It even helps the earlier rotations from the Centaur if he gets forced out of lane somehow, because we saw how much we had that struggle from Velo in game three, right? Or was he on the Centaur? Or game two, I suppose it was, when he was on the Centaur and he got forced out. And, well, speaking of the devil, I mean, OD comes to the conversation, so Nyx comes to the brain, and CG will snag it up for themselves. So that secures Rappy's hero. Slider will be in position four, and we look towards our mid versus OD left in the pool.
Not an easy matchup, especially when you know you're going into that. You just kind of go like, all right, I'll try to suck as least as I can. But it's going to be really hard to actually win that lane, even with dedicated support. And Warriors, I'm just saying, don't even try touching our heroes. We got an Omni Knight. He'll heal us up. He'll make us magic immune. Suddenly, you can no longer right-click when you got the Guardian Angel going. It is real nasty.
Interesting pick, though, because now that means they're not going to have any pressure on the mid lane. And if you're up against an OD, you basically just want to like make sure you can utilize your jungle a little bit too. Like you're on Radiant side, so you just kind of want to run away from OD, not have to deal with them too much. I think Invoker would be fine. We've seen some teams even go back for the Ember, even up against OD, despite it being like a ridiculous counter. If there's no position four, like pressuring in, and you just want to like head to the jungle, there is that potential. There is the Alchemist, who could be very strong in this situation for clutch gamers, I would say. Like who's going to come mid and mess with you besides the OD? Like, yes, he's annoying, but you don't really have that much to worry about, honestly.
10 seconds.
Wonder if
remaining.
This Nyx is going to have the new Nyx set that we all just witnessed.
I was looking at that.
It
is a crab.
Awesome. He looks like
supposed
a weird
to be like a lobster crab shell
lobster.
Kind of thing.
All right, let's just reserved. Oh yeah, he's a crustacean right there. Ooh.
Yeah, I was eyeing that myself. Actually, I was a little confused. But final ban here. Let's see what clutch gamers want. What they shall do. I guess, well, we've already talked enough about their whole mid idea. Assumed position one for Warriors Gaming, the Drow would have been pretty handy. Make OD even more powerful and potent. And I guess they have to choose now, too. It's a little bit of a tough call here. They can make a deny play, perhaps. Maybe take the Invoker for themselves. Right. We're back to top. I was discussing, right? My bad.
Yeah, we're just theory crafting. Ain't gonna hurt no one. This seems like just the perfect game for a Terrorblade, man, if I ever saw one.
Look how good Ember is at farming the jungle, guys. They still ban Ember. They're just like, you know what, screw it. Even though we have OD, it's considered like the best. It's Ember in lane.
Pretty much all teams in this tournament have a little PTSD from getting screwed on by an Ember.
Does leave the Tinker, though, who we always talk about as being that big ban remaining. Out. But we'll see. I think it could work okay with the Clutch Gamers lineup. They want to opt in towards it. Has a lot of the same qualities as the Alchemist or the Ember in terms of like farming jungle and stuff too. So probably something along those lines for CG.
Clutch usually run Tinker? Like, do they have their mid? Is that accomplished Tinker
player? Oh, yeah. Yeah, they have a good Tinker player for sure. So. Aaron Mel's played a lot of good heroes this tournament, and he's been playing some other tournaments too. I've definitely seen them win a game on Tinker. So, see here.
I remember a Shadow Fiend from a couple of days ago. Holy moly, that thing destroyed cities.
I feel like a PA would be kind of sick here.
Eh.
For Warriors, because they have the Omni Knight already. She'll be in the safe lane. She can jump on top of the Luna. And with Repel, they have nothing that goes through the BKB. Oh. Plus, they're using a lot of physical damage because you're buffing with Corrosive Haze and the Lunar Blessing. And that gives a lot of bonus to your evasion. But
Juggernaut.
Instead, they go for a Jug.
That's just the staple. Very, very safe offlaner. Very common. Or safe laner, rather. And pretty easy to farm up. Straightforward. We saw Psyonix have some trouble with them in the last series. But Warriors, maybe they'll run it differently. I think it's in the capable hands.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, it's certainly much safer than something like PA. You know, if you go into a fight and you get Sackstormed, you do just, like, lose the game. So there's undoubtedly a little bit of risk in that sort of a play. And there he is, Mr. Tinky Dink.
That's not what you call him.
Well, I just did. Yeah, I think Tinker and Alchemist were like definitely the two heroes. Tinker, the more tried and true Southeast Asia one, or at least it seems to be the most feared one with all these bans.
Yeah, definitely agree. It's one of those situational heroes where you know, 90% of the time you don't have to band it, but that 10% where Tinker gets off to a crazy start and he's split pushing down your racks at 20 minutes, you are just crying. So we'll see if Warriors are going to take the hit for game number one. Again, we're in a best of three. So this is game one, just a little bit of experimenting going on, trying to read each other, trying to figure out who's strong, who's riding that momentum. Warriors just coming off of a very nice three-game series, but they could be a little bit fatigued. We'll see if Clutch is going to take advantage of that.
Yeah, I think that definitely should come to the equation, right? It's 10 p.m. there. They already did what feels like a long day with that one match already. And here we go again. So we start. Oh, where's this one going? Down bottom. Oh, look at that lovely animation of that Centaur War Runner down there.
Where?
He's TPing the shrine. So, by the way, I did do the investigation. You can see that on the thing, you can see the four horns, right? So it is,
the
cosmetics do show.
All right.
There you go, guys. We're learning about this new feature. But we still don't know about the size thing.
Is that
I don't
supposed
know.
To say XD? Oh, okay.
XD, yeah.
All right. Like, a little bit of a misplace of the S and the K, but we'll let you off with a warning this time. I like the teepee. I wish it had a colored ring, because sometimes it's kind of hard to read, especially if there's a bunch of teepees at once. We got some tic-tac-toe going on the Dire side of the map.
Stupid game.
I think Juggernaut had enough of that. So how's your day going, Trent?
It's great.
Is that
you? I had some pizza. Some leftover pizza that my wife brought home. It was great. Tasty. Thoroughly enjoyed that. I'm trying to read what they're writing, but shit? Is that ah shit? As in ah shit?
I think that was ah shit as in an exclamation of distaste.
Ah shit. I think X Nova just wrote ah shit.
Oh, we got some
eyes. Oh, they're drawing.
Oh, here we go. That is some art. Oh, looks like a Juggernaut went in. He got the middle square of the tic-tac-toe, but wasn't able to actually close out a three in a row. So in frustration, just scribbled on the board.
Yeah, they're not very tired. They're fine. Look at them. They're ready to go. They're scribbling. They're having a good time. These guys gotta do the battle, eh? They gotta make their way through open qualifiers in the regionals. Because they replaced Kang with Ben back in January, so... good luck to them there. Looking forward to watching some of those.
Yeah, it's going to be a long road up, I think. Mr. Cat, very good training for the qualifiers that are going to be heated. Again, no direct SEA invite, so all these teams, once again, going to be pitted head-to-head for those craved spots. They really want to get themselves to the Kiev Major.
I think they're not going to do any shenanigans here with their Juggernaut or their Luna.
Oh, I see shenanigans happening everywhere. It's all shenanigans.
Well, in terms of lanes.
No, they're going to do it. They're going to rotate. We're going to have a Rubick mid. Centaur is going to be your safe laner. OD
right.
Support.
Okay. Makes sense.
Yep. That's my predictions.
I was actually thinking about OD support the other day. Could it work? Like, could you actually do it? And I decided the determining factor is simply Astral being... The level, the cast range is too brutal, you know?
Yeah, you have to
I was
get
thinking
up
maybe
in
you
there.
Could be Shadow Demon essentially, but then utilize like max the auras, and then you're just like this crazy aura fountain that walks around, but not quite good enough, guys. The cast range is too bad. This is why Pudge could never be a support until they changed that hook thing, that his hook's just insane at level one now. So much better.
Hey, it's still a little gimpy, but it gets the job done.
I mean, it's like 1,000 range though. It's like 5 times the range of Nana.
That's true. Nana would have to, like, just be in your personal space. Well, no rune snipes going on. A little bit of aggressive vision coming out on top. We've got the Radiant Ward here. Little Scarecrow revealing what's going down. But for the most part, everyone's sticking to their own side of the map.
So, support Omni is something we have seen a couple times down in Southeast Asia now.
Oh.
Not the most common thing.
Look at that. Disruptor gets lifted and stomped. Already they're going in aggressively. Disruptor going to be casting out the Kinetic Field to buy time. Crush in from Boombox. And well, this Tri-Lane is so sustainable. Omni and Centaur sharing the same lane. I mean, good luck killing them.
And they'll just bring X-Nova up top and try and zone out Rappy a bit here. So basically, you take the Rubick down there, try and get the kill level 1. But if you don't do that, then you just bring him up top and try and work towards the Snyx, who also didn't even start with the Stout. So actually, Rappy, slight punishment here. But I mean, you know, 3 tangos, a salve. Not too big of a deal when you have that much HP regen.
I'm thoroughly disappointed we don't have the new Nyx set to show off.
Okay, I mean, it's so ugly. Who wants that thing?
Whoa.
There's so many better Nyx sets. I mean, nothing's ever going to beat that, like, Chinese building one. I don't even understand why people even make other sets for Nyx.
What are you talking about? That set's so good.
It's like a pagoda or whatever the term is. It looks awesome.
On a Nyx?
Yeah. It is, like, the greatest thing ever.
Well, I have never seen that, apparently.
You haven't lived.
Guess not. All right.
Nope.
A little bit of a running in the jungle as Boombex wants to go and make a pass. Afu, he's trying to stack so hard. Boombex will allow it for now. It's going to be some casual farming. Ben gets pretty low here as Omni dips out to go help the mid lane, so Ben left to his own devices.
Regeneration.
Boombex, you're rotating pretty deep there, man. You are under vision. Sure, we get a bounty room, but what's it going to cost you? There's a shrine up, so Centaur, he's ready to go. It's going to be a battle of the crushes. Who's going to go first? Crush or stomp? Yeah, looks like Crush wins out this time.
What a hero.
Oh, absolutely. Now Armel in the mid lane. There's a Rubick getting a little bit close. Nana looking to go and start things off with an Astral, but like you mentioned, just look at that range. He's got to be in his shit, trying to bait him out to his side of the river. And there we go, there's the Astral. Does the Rubick rotate in? He's making his way towards the river. Very dangerous fight. Armel does still have the laser now, but he's gonna get lifted up and dropped back down. First blood comes in as Armel just tries to go pick up a last hit before he drops.
That's a nice play by X-Nova. I mean, we talked about the lack of position fours that could help rotate and stuff. And when you're that deep though, and even just Rubick telekinesis, but it's all because of that early point in the arcane orb, which we don't always see from OD, of course. But I guess the tinker, try and slow him down early. Good choice here by Nana.
Nana sitting a little bit low. Gonna get that bottle off the courier, so they're just slotting up now. Do we think this tinker's gonna go all the way in for that, you know, laser march of the machines, or is it gonna pick up the missile and try to at least fight a little bit? Because right now he's just definitely going for that I push, I don't touch heroes kind of build.
Yeah, basically he knows he's not going to get any help mid, I think. Too much focus down bottom to secure the Luna's farm instead. There's no way that he can set up for a slide-eye rotation, so he doesn't even bother like saving the points. Like, he's not even spamming March yet, but he still has it skilled up. He knows that it's not going to be rocketing anytime soon, but he can still hold like 5 and 6 points, trying to go for a burst play if the opportunity arises. Like, you don't really need 3 points march for any reason.
Oh no, I messed up my bindings. How did that rebind? What the hell? My Q has always been my last hits. I'm sorry, guys.
Ben is in trouble bottom.
Yeah. He's going, he's stomping around. He delayed the inevitable for as long as he could.
Yeah, even Glimpse still there too in the end, so no real problems for them. Good setup, just a quick zip out of the trees, Lucid Beam. He thought the slider must have been rotating or something, just, you know, I guess sometimes he got like 3 or 4 last hits before he died, so perhaps he's gonna consider, Gary. Gotta be a little bit cautious about those TPs, you know, even level 1 Glimpse. Fly Soul finds you like that. That can really hurt your laning stage, but won't get caught out this time. I'll be allowed to stay.
Nick's going to be salving up. He's been taking a lot of damage, but Nova goes in. He's able to get that Fade Bolt off, so that salve is nullified. A couple more hits will do it. Oh, can Hana actually get out? Unfortunately, X-Nova able to get that low ground hit. He's got it. You there, Mop Packs?
Yeah, sorry. My phone was was beeping.
Oh no, not the beepings.
I know.
That means it's doomed, dude. Time to get a new phone.
Okay, it's just dying its way there, so. No, we're all good. Actually, it was my brother texting me, and I was worried he'd give me Legend of Zelda spoilers.
Oh, dude, no, not the spoilers.
Yeah, Armel, right?
They've got telekinesis. Really surprised they let Armel live there. It looks like Nana really still wants to go in for this. Ex Nova, the hesitation from the Rubik may have just cost them this kill. Nana's still really trying to lay in the damage, but Boombex is right there with the crush. Ex Nova?
Oh, he's living.
This guy lives life on the edge, man.
Tried to get in there for the Fable at the end of the Astral, but not able to find it. So Tinker survives. He was Reign of Terror. And chased down by illusions. Ex Nova. So yeah, things just relatively chill. I mean, we're just kind of waiting for those levels. 6 on Tahana up here. Be the important one. Probably going to be a gank. I guess bottom, honestly. Mid's going to be relatively difficult because they have no levels in the rocket. Armel's just thinking about farm. Not going to find any stacks this 7 minute though, even with like illusions and boombox. So a little bit of a efficiency error there, I would say. Better be considering those with your Tinker. No reason not to be stacking with illusions.
Slardar hanging around. Looks like Exnova's gonna ping out that there is a fish waiting in the wing, so OD's gotta play a little bit safe. It was not your fate. So how's the pace of the game looking? I mean, we're 7 minutes in, we've had 3 kills total so far, definitely calmer than the last series, but when's the action really gonna start picking up?
Yeah, more than likely just our next assassin, but he doesn't have the easiest rotation, so like I want to say it's like he'll just start vendettaing stuff, but his lane's getting pushed in constantly from Jug, who, by the way, Ajit has had a totally free lane. I mean, we haven't really talked about it, but he's just been doing nothing but farming, and it shows in the net worth, but he has no pressures to worry about. Glimpse rotations don't really affect you, so a solid pick from them over inside of WG. And the group up option for Nana is probably gonna start looking pretty scary, right? He'll have his Midas soon, and then once he moves into that first big item, then that's when he's ready to just go with his Omni Knight. So he's mid now. They have a sentry ready for it though.
Oh, nice Astral right at the last second. There is gonna be a glimpse back though. Disruptor wants to get this going. Nice kinetic field. The Centaur ult holding the OD safely at a distance. So no blood spilled just yet. Lots of rotations in towards the mid lane, but you can see there, Ajit is like, all right, no kills are happening. Didn't get a chance to Omni Slash. Let's go back to farming ASAP. Not wasting any time here.
Yeah, and that's the idea of the more difficult rotations. Like, level 2 in the Carapace, so kind of hard for him to... Ooh, nice stun top onto Ajit, but even with all this follow-up, I don't think they can kill him. They would need, like, the Vendetta damage and, like, another stun or something. They get half his HP down, and his courier still just shows up.
I mean, they've got another crush now if they want to try something, but Ajit can just go spin away. He's also got the Omni Slash to turn things, especially with, you know, how few creeps are in the area. Meanwhile, Ben on the Centaur finding a little solo farm for himself. Our scent is level 7, almost level 8, and he's picking up the hood. No surprises there.
Yeah, their initiation is pretty late on the side of Warriors Gaming, right? As I said, typical hood first, so looking for that blink dagger. But they're much more about just like the 5-man Dota, and they'll just be stampeding onto your face if you try and contest us at towers. I'm a little intrigued to see what Nano will opt for in terms of his itemization. I don't think it's really a Veil game. Like, sometimes we still get to see that every once in a while, but... He doesn't have the best allies to utilize it. On the other hand, it does give you a little bit of armor against the Slardar and stuff, so... Oh, nice double stun. That was pretty good. Hannah will take up the Bounty Rune here and just uses Vendetta. Near sentry, but not under... Oh, maybe it clipped? Yeah, it clipped, actually. He went just past it.
Speaking of clips, we got an Eclipse going on. Ben, gonna be eating most of that. He goes, he stomps up the Luna. She's got a Lucent Beam, but she can't... Oh,
got him.
She got him. That's the range. And that is a lot of damage coming out. Meanwhile, Hana is able to find the kill onto Ex Nova. Ajit spinning, really wants to get the return kill onto the Nyx, but doesn't bring enough damage just yet.
That's a nice TP. Just immediately.
Now there's going to be a glimpse back. Fortunately,
but
Hana.
Hasted.
I mean, he's hasted, flies solo. He's got that kinetic field, man. One more. Gonna feed that right to Nana. That's a fair chunk of gold. It's 215 going straight to the OD. He's already got himself a Midas.
Oh, Apu bottom.
Yeah, that's a deep little dive there from our Luna. Slardar hits the deck. Ah, Bingos, and tries to TP out. The hoof stomp going to be just a little bit late. They can't lock the Luna down, and she is having a fun time right now. She's matching up with the OD in terms of net worth. She's already got herself a headdress, and it looks like we're going to be picking up a full helm very shortly.
All right, so a little aggressive, but lives. So I think it's okay.
Yeah, diving tier 2s at 11 minutes in. It's pretty solid.
Middle tower. A way to see exactly what Nana wants to do, honestly. I feel like his item choice is surprisingly important this game. But I guess overall, the pace of the game in terms of what they're going to do won't change too much no matter what he grabs. This is what you'd expect, right? You rotate your position one at the safe lane, give a little space to X Nova. We saw him get super greedy in some of their games earlier today where he had this exact same situation where the energy booster queued up, but then he just got all this gold together and bought himself a blink. So not expecting that same amount of freedom though with them having the Luna up here. They're doing their counter pressure.
Nana goes right into this. Boombex goes, lands the crush, but they don't have any follow-up. There's gonna
they're
be TPs
TPing
to the
a lot
shrines.
Of people top too.
Fly solo, able to get the glimpse off onto the OD. Not gonna go for something cheeky like a glimpse onto one of the heroes that just TP'd as you don't want to get too close. Meanwhile, top lane, we've got a deep dive. Luna does not know the meaning of personal space as she wants to get up in this. Her Eclipse tragically close to being ready, but Dire, they rotate the heroes they need.
That was really aggressive for just having a purge creep.
Dude, purge creeps win games.
Not that time.
I mean, you don't know that.
I don't.
That purge creep is probably the reason why Clutch Gamers are going to take game one.
Good decision by Warriors Gaming, though. They took their advantage. They send the Juggernaut down bottom. He secures the tower down there, and immediately they're able to defend their top lane. So they're going to be one up on towers. They don't necessarily have to focus this one down, but they force enough rotations up here that they can move themselves around the map. They just need to be cautious about Nyx rotations at the same time. And he shows up mid with the Vendetta. But doesn't really have a buddy. No Sunstrikes this game. There's no bots yet here on there. Well, there's bots, I suppose, but there's no blink. So we can't like be there every time for the Vendetta. Don't have your giant reach of mobility yet.
Nana's starting
so
to
it's
look
just
like
a...
Go ahead.
Oh, he's just like a bounty hunter. You know what I mean? Like he's more like information gathering right now than actually killing.
It's still relatively early. Jit could be the target of all this damage, walking away with his healing ward, but Nyx doesn't want to reveal to the tower, facing a solo Omni Slash, so he's just relaxing. Got Marching Machines, will make quick work of these creeps. Tinker can just go TP out, meanwhile top lane, some decent pressure being exerted by our little trio here.
The Tinker, did you see that? The bots? I guess they fixed it, so the bots animation does do something, because I saw people say there was no thing, but it just puts like a hologram Tinker on top of units.
It's pretty cool.
Pretty comical.
Is it like standing on their head, or is it inside them?
Yeah, it was like literally standing on its head. He was like riding the catapult.
Alright, I gotta keep an eye out for that.
But yeah, WG, I think this Nyx Assassin is going to have a very hard time, honestly. He needs to make big plays with Carapace during these actual teamfights because his gank potential this game is just so
speaking
low.
Of gank potential, they get the glimpse back onto the Centaur. There's that Tinker I'm talking about. Comes in on top of the Purge Creep. Dude, Purge Creeps win games! They're getting this fight. They don't get a kill, but that doesn't nullify my point.
No, of course not. X-Nova, super sneaky here. Oh, X-Nova.
Solo comes back in. They got the crush. The hoof stomp not going to be in time. All the Radiant heroes just making themselves at home under this tier 1 tower. The tower is so low. They can't finish it off just yet. The catapult doing a fair share of work, but I feel like if Radiant had just hit the structures, they would have avoided all that tower damage they took for the last 30 seconds.
Well, they win that engagement again. Good rotations from the side of Warriors Gaming. Gold going to Juggernaut, and it's 5-man Dota time. There's really no reason for them to start splitting up again. Maybe Ben will take some time to like farm up his Blink Dagger and stuff, but they can just always group as 5, force a new objective, bring the entirety of CG there, and then they can just kind of like walk away. So many things on CG prey on being alone, like Tinker and Slardar, even Disruptor with these glimpses, Nyx Assassin too. But if you just want to start grouping up and using these item advantages that you have, they're going to be very strong. Like they almost have a Dragonlance on Nana now too.
I feel like Clutch Gaming did not have to throw their bodies into the fire under that tier 1. You got this momentum from Luna. She wants to go in. She has a really high burst damage. But if it doesn't go her way immediately, she just doesn't back out. That's so far cost her 2 deaths. Armel having a fun time here, just hopping in and out of the wave. Nana able to clean up most of the damage. And meanwhile, up top, we do have
Hana. Coming with the blink, too. Yeah, they might even deny out Ben's blink here, too. This is going to be a big play.
Oh, he's so
they
close.
They have the Static Storm for rotations and the Glimpse, too.
He's so close.
Yeah. Ben's definitely... He should be dead.
Hey, they got him. All right, yeah. That's a dead Centaur unless he can ult and run the speed of light. He's out of there. Meanwhile, mid lane, things still going all right for WG. Putting out a decent amount of pressure. Ajit getting some good farm on the Juggernaut. Overall net worth, he'll be second right behind his OD. Who has a double damage rune in the bottle of a finished Hurricane Pike. There we go. Ajit spinning around, looking to defend this. Ah Bing does have the Eclipse ready to go.
So much pressure on this Tinker this game. Like, he's the one that can really dictate the movements of Warriors Gaming. And we talk about how, like, their 5-man is very strong, but if you can pull them to the wrong parts of the map and then punish the opposite end with your Luna and then, like, the other lane with your Tinker, then even if they're running around as 5 heroes, you won't be getting kills with your Nyx and everything, but you still have a lineup capable of doing like economic growth for your side, so... I think CG are in a pretty good spot here. Warriors Gaming, like, they have the opportunity to win, I feel like, but I do think it is difficult to execute this kind of a strategy where you kind of feel pressured to 5-man, and they'll have that opportunity once Ben does have his delayed blink after that death.
Still... Clutch Gamers hanging around mid lane. Hana was scouted out. They know there's a Vendetta Nyx somewhere in the area. It's hard to actually get a hold of him. Staying right outside the sentry. Ajit just continues to spin. He's far forward here. I wonder if he's going to get caught out. Yeah, there's the glimpse back. But he's able to go and be repelled off by the Omni. So he's going to dodge that. Tower still stands, but Warriors Gaming investing a lot of time and resources just to keep everyone here trying to defend that tier 1. Juggernaut just gonna bail out, go back to farming, taking some ancients, and shouldn't be too difficult for Tinker just to shove this one down in the meantime.
Yeah, they're gonna smoke up with the blink dagger here on Ben. Clear out the tower first. Understandable. And they can just end up denying this, honestly.
Oh, up in the top lane, it's a double damage OD.
Great timing.
Oh, they got him. It's going to be in some serious trouble. He could go for the self-astral, but all it's doing is delaying the inevitable. They go in the centaur ult and the force staff. He's going to be astraled, glimpsed back. Oh my. OD comes back from the dead pretty much and is going to be swinging still. That was a clutch play right there, showing off that new Hurricane Pike. And the solo Omni Slash gets the Disruptor. Oh, the Hoofstomp cancels the TP at the last possible second. They get the double edge. And Hana, I mean, he could Carapace, but... can he actually escape from this? The OD is still going forward. The Omni did a great job going with that repel. And yep, that's going to be 2 heroes dead. Meanwhile, bottom lane, upping, find some space. We'll find a tower, but that was a beautiful save. OD.
Dragonlance Dota.
Yeah.
I mean, he has 13 armor. It's not that bad compared to, I mean, you're up against Slider and stuff, so obviously it's going to be reduced pretty heavily, but damn.
Ben, I mean, he's not stopping. They're riding this momentum. Ah Bing, though, on the Luna. Very upset at the way things are going. There's a Sanity's Eclipse. Glimpse back onto the OD, holding her back for now. Ah Bing is so low, but Ajit is stuck in the kinetic field. Can't catch up right now. Luna's going to live. They sacrifice their Slardar. But I guess it's worth it to keep your position one up and fighting.
Yeah, I think she definitely would have died if he didn't blink and then crush there. And Centaur could have found the angle, so a worthy play. But this is where they would do run into some trouble, right? Like, I think they had it going because they had that thing where, like, they were stuck mid for a while because they're trying to deal with all this march and push, deny the tower, smoke up and everything. And all that while, they almost jumped on that OD, right? And had they actually gotten that kill, those rotations come in, you're still fighting strong. But painful when you don't find that, right? Like, all that work that you've been doing with your Tinker and trying to split push and find those opportunities to get a pick off onto an OD like that and then you fail is... very painful to the strategy overall. So It's gonna get Nana even tankier, because that's heading in towards an Atos.
Yeah, I was just taking a look at the overall XP chart, and it is really Warriors Gaming favored, like significantly more than the net worth, and that's just because Radiant spent so much time just grouping up as five. You can see even right now, they're all just kind of hanging around this tier one spot, not really soaking experience, splitting it really thin, whatever they are soaking, so the levels are coming out much slower. You look at OD, he's already, you know, level 17 and a half, and your highest is your Luna, who's just barely level 14.
17, that's actually insane. Holy
it is
shit.
It is 21 minutes and our OD is almost level 18.
That is unreal. I mean, involved in fights, obviously, a lot of people dying. Sticks 0-2, it has a Midas. But wow, that's like a bad Meepo game levels of experience, though. That's crazy.
I like how you have to preface it with a bad Meepo game.
Oh. Yeah, I mean, okay, mediocre. It's not even bad.
It's like a lukewarm Meepo game. Oh, we got a fight breaking out here as X-Nova goes in. Oh, no way. The stolen Eclipse. At least doing a little bit of zoning work, allowing for some serious pressure onto this tower. Nana should be able to finish this one off. Well played, Rubik. Goes in, drops a ward, pushes back the entire Radiant squad. And now tier threes, potentially up for grabs in this bottom lane.
Even gets him towards his Blink Dagger, too, with that kill, so... Vendetta now as well. Have a little bit of time to scout out what the Radiant are up to. He's fly solo. Bottle under some boards here. Hurricane Pike in one.
That's a three-shotter. Nana's not able to do that. Oh god, the Mud Golem! He didn't do anything here. Luna's just going forward. I guess it was a very complicated bait all along. Now Luna's in some trouble, surrounded by three. They're half health, a little late on the Guardian Angel, but they may still find the kill. Luna will get stomped, will die. The Omni Slash ricocheting around. Gonna hit onto Hana too, gets Juggernaut back up to the high ground, although he's taken some significant damage from Hana, and Armel coming in as well.
Nice.
He'll find a triple kill with the laser. Ajit just gonna be going and shrining up, so what a bloody little engage there, Hana. Potentially looking for more. Has the Midas ready. Impale
they got
connects.
So much
They've
gold.
Got the Thunderstrike. Can they actually hold the Jug in place here? He's spinning. He's able to walk through the kinetic field, but he's fresh out of mana. Got a TP coming in from Afu. X-Nova makes his way forward as well, and they're just going to be probably shrining up for mana. Juggernaut's a little bit thirsty for it. There he goes.
I think they got 900 gold on Armel, and then another 900 onto our next Destinier for Hannah Rappi. And then 600 for the Luna, too, despite dying. That's like a massive comeback for them. And all starting with a glimpse, or rather a gank onto that Disruptor. Just counterplay it. Tinker finds himself a bunch of kills, and definitely showing off the power of Tinker Slider. I mean, it's just like Tinker Bounty. Whole idea of as long as you're Cross of Haze or tracked up, those missiles will find you. The search range is just gargantuan. I mean, if you highlight over it, it's...
Yeah.
You know, sometimes it's hard to really grasp how...
That's what we're talking about. You have to zoom.
It's
if you
huge.
Zoom all the way out, you can see the borders there. That green line is where the heat-seeking missiles will find you if there's vision of you. So, there we go. Let's zoom back in. Let's keep it controlled. Now, there is going to be a scan. Radiant know what's up. But can they actually get to the pit in time? It's an early Roche. It's melting down slowly, but it seems like Dire will be able to score this one for themselves.
Good, grab for them. Try and solidify their positioning. I mean, this was always the classic of OD, right? You get a lineup, you five man starting at 20 sub minutes, you get a couple towers, then you go Roche, and you try and just put a stranglehold on the game that's impossible to come back from. So, this is their time. They still have a decent enough lead to do it.
That's the Omni making this so easy. Afu can just keep up those repels on the cores that are actually going forward and face checking the wave, and they're not going to get popped by anything. We mentioned it in the draft.
They know Armel's here. Oh, I thought maybe they were going to find that one actually, but
nah, he's good. He was in the trees. I mean, what scouting tools do WG have? You can kind of go for a lucky blink on the Centaur, but there's not anything like a Wave of Terror or a Sunstrike to give pretty easy reveal.
Well, should give Armel relatively safe game for sure. Gotta watch those. You know, sometimes you get a little excited, get a stampede going or something like that, and maybe they'll get fortune on a blink. But yeah, for the most part, should be relatively fine. Has his Aghanim Scepter finished up whenever he wants to sack his buyback. And they're in it for the long haul, right? They have some great high ground defense heroes. Force Staff actually picked up by Hannah here, so not going to save straight for the Aghanims. Not feeling that pressure quite yet.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
To watch himself here, though. Don't think his allies are coming for this tower.
Definitely getting to that point where Warriors game in. Like we saw in series number one, they just get a lead and they roll with it. The difficult part is trying to, you know, roll with it harder than a Tinker can go split push you. We see down bottom we're going to have a little bit of a tier 2 for tier 2 trade. Both teams are fortifying. They want to delay this. Luna Illusions eventually do finish it off.
Hit deny, too.
Nice.
Close. Didn't think he was going to get it.
Flint's back in. The Astrold OD. And he's waiting. And they'll find him eventually. Oh! Got the Aegis. He's surrounded. How does our OD get out of this one? I don't think he's doing that. I don't think he's getting out.
No. Certainly not. So, excellent grab. They goof a little bit there. I'm not sure. Obviously, we were watching the bottom lane for the most of part of that, so no repels or anything to save him. Sticks around a little bit too long, it seems. Caught out by the glimpse, and very well played by CG. Not only do they have the great high ground, like, you can maybe lose one hero when you're getting those objectives, but the tier 2 top and you lost tier 2 bottom is a very big win for CG. Have Vendetta to lead here as well.
Oops, smoke is going to break. They know someone's up on this high ground. Slardar brings forward. He's searching. Juggernaut's going to be magic immune, so they can't actually continue with that glimpse. Would have been a great pick, but unfortunately going to go home empty-handed.
Definitely feels like CG weathered the storm. I mean, they knocked down that Aegis. They made it through that early start of the game where WG were starting to get into a pretty scary spot, right? Considering it was that early, it's like 14 minutes, and they're hitting up into close to a 3,000 gold lead. You get a little bit worried, a little concerned, but they weren't able to pressure fast enough. That pick off onto Ben, I think, was really important to slow down his own Blink Dagger. And then the subsequent tower pressure that they had going on, making it difficult for them to five-man group up around this OD. Delayed the Roche a little bit further. They kept getting their items up, and now they're in a good spot. They have good initiating tools from the Nyx Assassin, from the Slardar, split push from Armel, and the itemization that's going to come out to stop this Tinker is so far away.
Yeah, it's tricky. I feel like, I mean, Warriors Gaming are having a pretty solid vision problem. We see there the Centaur was on top of the Vendetta Nyx. He's got dust, but they just got no way of knowing that he's around, so Gem, hopefully going to be in order soon for the Dire Squad.
Yeah, they're almost to that point. Once they can close out that last tier 2 mid. The vision is really just killing them. Like, double wards here, just in case one of them was to get dewarded, they'll just go for both cliffs. Finding out a lot of what the Dire are up to over here. Though Radiant, very aware as to what they can and can't do. Let's see, be aggressive, farming things like these Ancients here, all of these neutral camps. Despite the Dire even have a little bit of vision in here themselves. Feeling very good for the Radiant's chances.
Yeah, they definitely...
A lot stronger.
I feel like this is a pattern that we've seen in every game with Warriors Gaming, that they get this huge spike of momentum around 20 minutes, and they push, and they get structures, and they're looking so strong, they just need to keep up that momentum. But they can't. And they just kind of fizzle off around this point pretty much every game. We'll see if Clutch Gamers is going to take advantage of that. Warriors game and try to get that fire back. They go in for a nice smoke, deep rotation. They kill off poor Potato near the Roche Pit, and they're hungry for more.
That's just the Spud. The big guy's the Red Potato.
That's
He's
Clappy.
Like the...
No, it's, well, it's
right.
Tomato
Sorry,
and Potato.
I forgot about your naming things. Oh yeah, that's also true. I was thinking like a Red Potato, but that is true. He's also the Tomato,
a red
so...
Red Potato, like one of the little circle ones.
Good ones.
Oh, good.
Tasty stuff. Alright, let me see this initiation prowess. Now there's no Aegis. Are we willing to fight? We just want to split push. We don't have a Tinker to lay down some marches.
We want to split push. There we go. Tinker's back. He's ready to go, but not before the tier 2 tower's down. And I like this play of a WG Unity. They're like, alright, we got the tier 2. We're unscratched. Just back the hell off. Do not make an attempt for high ground. Don't stay around to farm. And maybe they can even clean up a kill on the way on through to the top lane.
Can't quite find the Nyx. They'd be disappointed. I'm sure the bounty's gone.
There we go. Omnit with a gem.
The time. And man, they have been dropping those sentries everywhere too, so. Gonna try and get some Tinker wards up soon, I'm sure. I think Armel was here and the Sardar was pinging like, dude, they probably have wards there. You should be careful. Don't want to go too deep in those areas. And we eye up Rosh for the Dire side with the gem. Should be able to get some good vision control around the pit. Take it for themselves. The BKB likely to be the determining factor in that engagement for when the thing shows up. So if they can find the perfect moment for Fly solo, get a good stack storm off, maybe he can win that fight for them. Net worth negligible difference at this point in the game.
Yeah, really close. And I mean, even just the individual breakdown, pretty much everyone going head to head with their equal on the other team. And now that's the initiation we're looking for. The Juggernaut. Can he actually get out of this one? He's going to try to Manta, but he can't do it. Just not going to be enough of a save. Looks like there's going to be a glimpse back. Ben is going to be repelled off by the Omni Knight, so not going to get glimpsed and pulled. But there's still a significant amount of damage left to be unleashed by Clutch Gamers. They're breaking high ground here. The Luna, once she gets in, once she's actually able to chip damage onto these structures, they are melting.
Yeah, very well played.
Oh, they got the Atos here. OD, he's ready to go, but Luna's BKBing and running forward. OD is scared. Boombax is there to zone. Tier 3 tower goes back. They're not going to find that glimpse back again. Omni Knight, Repel, doing its job. Luna's going in for the Eclipse here. We'll get blown up. Boombex gonna be focused down. One hit from death. Can they actually chase down this Lardar? They do find him. Nyx Assassin goes in.
And got him.
Alright.
Stuck around a little too long. I mean, they got the tier 3, but then
Boombex
went
lived.
Downhill from there.
That was a miscall by me. I got confused with the Nyx and the Centaur, who somehow looked the same in that fight. But yeah, Boombex was able to actually worm his way out of that one.
Yeah. What's the number? Oh, the Astral is actually so confusing with the glimpse too, eh? Because
yeah,
like,
it goes away, the animation.
Yeah, it cancels it. So it looks like, because they can't actually tell, because it looks stupid for a CG, because they think, oh, he just got repelled right at the end. Like, you can't tell if he just got repelled way back in the back lines, or if he's actually just about to reappear there. So they still have to, like, bail out of there, or they might have nailed to kill the OD. So kind of annoying, but yeah, what can you do? You still wind up where you get glimpsed, you just can't really tell when he's going to show up.
Juggernaut, very ambitious play there. There's a TP cancel to the shrine, so I guess he's scary enough that no one wants to TP into him. Still sitting on that Omni Slash. He's going to be working on his Scotty, getting pretty close.
I like that choice. Make him a little bit tankier. Almost tempted maybe to think about a BKB this game. Obviously a horrific item on Juggernaut in most situations.
I mean,
but
he's also
Eclipse,
got an
Nyx.
Omni on his team. Like, how much... Like, that's silly. With an Omni and a Blade Fury, that...
I mean, I can agree. It's just, like, he's running into a lot of trouble with, like, his blinds, because he has the Manta so often anyway, and then this Nyx Assassin just going to be stunning you up, and he can only repel one person, so... it's either going to be Ben or him, and... Poor Ben. I guess he's going to buy his own BKB then, it looks like, anyway, so... There you go. Centaur's tank in the bullet, which means no Lotus Orb, which is also one of those key items that you need against, your Nyx Assassins and your Tinkers and your Slardars. Man, this is a sick Lotus game. Holy. I almost want Ben to actually just go Lotus anyway and just suck it up.
Do it. All right. Smoke in. Looks like Warriors game and trying to get aggressive, realizing that if they don't make some moves soon, this Luna is just going to go and start split pushing and chunking down towers in the base, and Tinker can do the same.
Really shows the difference between old Repel and new Repel too. Like, it's great that it can't be purged off, but man, that downtime, it just... I'm always blown away as to how much worse it is compared to the old Repel and the old Omni Knight.
Well, here we go. Trying to make their way up. Nana, just a little bit short of the high ground. Bing Mimel gonna BKB, Eclipse it off, and they're looking for something here. Centaur's ulting. There's gonna be that murder onto Clutch Gaming. They get the Disruptor early. Nyx to follow up, and they're looking for Bing as well. They get the Stomp. Nice kill. That's going to be super high value. Ben picking up the 400 gold from that.
That was pretty sick, eh? The ulti, and then he just runs high ground. Gets the Agatha Scepter. That's our Warrunner. What a hero. That was some good stuff.
Why not, man? Got that free pathing. Make the most out of it. And right
the
into the
CG
Roche pit.
Battled their way back in this game and then throw it on a high ground push. Lose another fight. Now Roche.
Warriors Gaming have a sizable lead here, Annie.
I do, but I mean, it's not really that much. If you look monetarily, it's going to be about 5,000 when this Roche is said and done for a 40-minute game. That's doable. I don't think Clutch Gaming should tap out just yet. I've seen how much work this Luna can do, and she actually gets up to the tier 3s. Bouncing around with all those blades, it'll make quick work of the racks as well.
No, certainly not tap out range yet, of course. I mean, they haven't even lost their tier 3s yet. We're still chilling with Shrines. We'll be okay for now, but yeah, certainly a little bit worrisome.
What? No, they got the bottom one.
No, I'm talking about Radiant.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's fine. It's basically like you have the Aegis on Ajit, which is great. So now you can focus your repels onto whoever you want from Afu, at least for the beginning. Just make sure you have one ready for when he comes back up. Or at least try and siege as long as possible with repels here too, of course. And tower hitting damage.
Oh, Link forward. Ben wants to get this started, but... Oh, holy man, Disruptor.
Shit. Was that intentional?
I don't know. This is chaotic. There we go. Guardian Angel coming forward. Ben, he's going to be BKB'd anyway. He doesn't really care. Ajit spinning in. They're not going to get him back, but they might find the Centaur here. He's lifted up. He's impaled. Meanwhile, Nana just starting to go to town on anyone crossing his path. We'll be able to find the Nyx. Ben, somehow still alive, finally finished off from the high ground. The gem will be safely picked up by the Omni Knight, though. And look at Nana. He's still going underneath the shrine. Fly Solo might be able to escape. Nope, it's still a triple kill for Nana, and they're going to go turn this immediately into structures. This is WG having the time of their life. They killed the Rubick, and they're going to be going back in ultra kill for Nana in terms of buybacks. They're few and far between for the Radiant. Tinker's going to spend his, but everyone else in the grave for their full death timer. WG, they back out for this curious play. I guess really scared of that Eclipse.
Back in. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Yeah, they're gone. So they win the fight. They get the buyback on the Tinker. They still have it, right? Yeah, they still have Aegis. So they can just regen back up, get all their heroes, have the Stampede ready to go, and everything's all set from there. But, well, goddamn, I'll be. That Manta, though. That was actually so sick.
I did like, not see what happened.
The game should have just been over. It was just like Blink, Stomp, Centaur, and just Manta.
Yep.
Dodge that thing out.
Locked down too much. I mean, of course, it's spectator bias to say, like, oh, WG probably could have got more structures off that, but the fact that they're playing safe and not going to throw away a lead and not going to give away any important kills really shows that they're maturing. They're getting better at their impulse control, and look at that net worth there with that successful fight and push. About 7,500 towards WG. Almost 15,000 experience in their favor. Taking a look at your guys' favorite chart, the levels. We've got our 25. On our Outward Devourer, and he's going to be picking up the extra Arcane Orb Insteel, so very into OD right now.
Yeah, good choice this game. I think that's usually what we go for. I mean, 8% just feels so lackluster compared to that skill, but really helps for sustained pushes, like fights that happen consecutively. And 2 minutes to go here on this push. Down bottom, Boombox is trying to split push. It's actually quite fine. I mean, he's got his BKB. 10 seconds. Ready to whip this one out. See if he gets an actual chance.
Disruptor buys here as well. A gem. Omni Knight definitely getting some serious value out of the gem he bought earlier. Who's holding it now? Or Centaur is. I like this choice. Centaur's just going to ult and run it to you so he can always stomp. He'll get a direct hit on the next assassin. No more sneaking around.
Looks like they're not committed to running down with this Aegis. It ain't gonna happen. They want the MKB perhaps first onto Ajit. Tired of this blind, can't handle it anymore, wants to just kill some heroes. I can agree with that.
Absolutely. I mean, right now it's looking good. We've talked about Warriors Gaming just being able to go and get one more easy team fight, finally getting down a full lane of racks, finally getting some super creeps, maybe even some mega creeps. What does Clutch Gaming have to do to play this smart? Like, what's their ideal initiation? How do they flip this right on WG's heads?
Just a good scythe is the biggest thing from Armel. He can do so much, but you saw last time, they just kind of killed everyone else, which worked out pretty well. Like, even though he was remaining, he can't actually just go in solo and do it all on his own. If you're just standing there and trying to rearm, someone will mess with you, so. Snap finished up here. They continue. Glimmer quickly from X-Nova.
That was
on the run.
Very fast on his feet. I missed most of that on my actual camera, but caught it on the mini-map. The source of all good action. But yeah, basically Tinker went, TP'd into the top lane, tried to just blink into the trees to be that inconspicuous, like, I'm just gonna go march here. And then there was a Rubick.
Pushing top, but there's a lot of pressure coming down in the bottom lane. 4:30 until Rouge, so 1, 2, 3, 4 and a half. So a minute and a half into our time there, not bad. Oh, yo, that Omni cape. That is hilarious.
What?
He's got like the Omni Knight cape. It's like the little Omni symbol. It's
great. Oh, yeah, yeah. I thought you were talking about like Jug's Omni Slash for a second, and I'm like, what?
No. Just a glorious cosmetic, Annie.
I'm sorry. I got an appreciation for some glorious cosmetics.
Well, a bing. It's happy butterfly, no longer so happy, of course. I'm looking forward to watching this MKB in action. I feel like Jug's finally going to hit people, you know? No more blinds.
Yep.
No more butterflies. It's all out the window here. Rappy, what did he end up for? He did go for the Yules. He has himself a Ghost Scepter, and he's now at least eyeing up that Aghanim Scepter. But they're still holding tier 3s, so I feel like if you're a Nyx and you've been pressured this long and you end up losing a Rax or something before you get the Aghanim Scepter, you're probably going to be pretty sad. Think about like how helpful it is in those situations, but he just needs that survivability. Can't get comboed up. So that seems to be his plan here.
Klona going to lead the charge.
Oh, it's all on you, Boombox.
Still a real scary proposition as there are gems hanging around. Ajit just spinning away, making sure no one's going to make quick work of him. And now Nana blinks forward. They would love to find some kills, but it seems like everyone's already bailed out of the situation. So a little bit of wasted time, wasted smoke from Clutch Gamers, but they don't lose anything there.
And Warriors Gaming just can't quite get a handle on these lanes. They don't want to send someone like Ajit all alone down bottom or anything like that to just get picked off. There is a blink scythe, so that's not really an option. And as you pointed out earlier, they still don't have the best way. Like, they have this Aghanim's on the Centaur to try and catch out Tinker and stuff, and they've got these wards. Oh, actually, it's a Radiant Ward up top, so they don't have any Dire Wards. Mantis being pushed out here, so I guess Gem's going to work. They're holding three wards onto X-Nova, but they need to find some way to catch out this Tinker. But I'm not sure how you do it. You know, he doesn't have his buyback for another minute, and they've had all this time to just one pick could have ended the game. But RML's been playing very well.
Yeah, really not giving anything away for free. We'll see if our OD is going to be going and doing anything cheeky here. Got Boombex and Wolf in the vicinity. TP from the Tinker as Hana's crawling around to the top lane. So some split push still coming up for Clutch Gamers. They're not definitely just going to, you know, roll over and let Warriors game and push wherever they want. Clutch still showing some signs of life, of course, with a Tinker. You can never really tap out.
Not getting anything off that Aegis in terms of like actual buildings is huge. They're going to try a smoke plane now, and this might work because the OD was here. I feel like they need to make like a beeline this way or something. They need to do something that's slightly unpredictable. You can't just be like following behind this OD unless they feel like that's the unpredictable thing, thinking that they'd actually be rotating somewhere else, which could be right. It's like a double mind game in a sense where this might be the one that actually tempts them into playing, do a bad fight.
We'll see. Smoke's still going to hold true. We've got Luna rotating. Gets herself back up to the high ground safely. But Nana still definitely a juicy target. We'll see if anyone's going to be fooled by this little bait. Smoke's going to expire. They're not ready, and I've got to know something's going on. Meanwhile, Ajit just starts to carve away at this tier 3. Very slow going here. Slow siege split between multiple lanes. Trying to slowly work down Clutch Gaming's patience.
Well, at least they've got two lanes pushed in now, so they've made their way into the important positioning. 40 seconds left until Roche and Shrines are now open. So big victory there. Spins away, no glimpse. Right. Good play.
Very well executed right now, and they're going to go straight in, start working on the Shrine. Definitely a good control point in the Radiant Jungle, but not as important as our top Shrine, which is going to completely control movement to the Roche pit. the Clutch Gamers are going to mount a little bit of a defense here, rotating Hana forward, but gotta be really careful against Centaur, still holding on to that gem and a fly solo. He's walking all alone. And now we're just trying to push this out, but we do have the Tinker Ward here. This is called the Tinker Ward because it's revealing exactly what Armel's doing as a Tinker. And a lot of information now for the Dire side, rotating forward Ben. Tantalizingly close to Boombex here. Boombex is going to get the jump on him. They've got the impel from Hana to follow up, but look at Nana. He's ready to go. Immediate scythe onto the Nyx, and they finish him off. There's a BKB rocket onto Boombex. They've still got some damage. He goes for the TP out. He's magic immune. Do they have the damage? No! Just barely able to get himself back to base. Well played by the Slardar. Quick reaction there, but there's still a Nyx assassin down, and that's going to make it really difficult to defend high ground unless he buys back.
That's a fight that... Look what the Nyx just drew. You see that line? That's a fight that doesn't work anymore. And I think they realize that now. Like, old Dota, that fight works. Like, you see that as the victorious because you're the hero who has a Tinker on your team. But you can see what Nyx drew. He's like, wait, there's this thing now. They can just TP right there. Like, we're basically fighting next to a tier 1 in that scenario. But it doesn't feel like it in old Dota, you know? So they just... Like, there's no way you get that kill on the Centaur unless Tinker's actually there. He can't be TPing back to base when you're initiating. I think that was a little bit of an error there from CG, and they immediately realized it.
Why are the hexes blue? Like, is that normal?
It's the battle pass.
Oh, jeez. Okay. Did not even see that. There we go. Is that the Lotus Orb hex? Look at that little piggy go with a centaur ult. He was really scampering around. But right now, Warriors Gaming, they're going to have some of their spells burned down, some of their items on cooldown, but they are still full health, full mana, and they're ready to charge. Ajit going to be repel these Blade Fury. He's spinning himself to victory. They at least have half a lane of super creeps coming in. Nice stomp there by Boombex. Finding what he needs. The crush is on point, but the BKBs are rolling. Bing thinking about going for the Eclipse. Will be able to find what he needs, but Dire, they're still holding strong. It's a godlike streak for Nana. They cannot afford to lose the OD here. Bing still walking around, still looking for something. Fly. Nana, please relax! What? Why did he go back in? He just fed 1,000 gold to the Tinker. 1,000 gold.
At least he had buyback penalty.
1,000 gold for the chance at getting down a disruptor. That was greedy.
Yeah, maybe a little bit. They will probably get themselves Roche now. They don't have Corrosive Haze, but of course at this point your Luna hits so hard that it can be a humongous concern. Low Roche.
1,000 gold. I love the Roche hex, the giant
pig. To be fair, it's only like 400 though, because it gets reduced by 60%.
I mean, okay.
He's dead.
Well, Armel's now dead, so all that gold is going back the other way. Bing flew too close to the sun. There's going to be a glimpse away. They still got him. They still got him. Fly solo this time goes down. WG feeling strong once again. They got their momentum back after a... arguably extremely greedy attempt, but now they're going to go through, most likely able to finish off the full set of racks, chug towards bottom as well. There's a buyback on the Luna, but Tinker is still in the fountain for his full death duration. Ben with a nice blink, juking out the crush, and now they're going to punish Boombex. He's BKB'd up, Disruptor's TPing in here. This could be a little dangerous. Ajit maybe in some trouble, lift up. Oh man, they got this. X Nova, the Rubik plays are going to be there. Ben, he's charging on through that kinetic field. He's getting so low, they lose their centaur. Now Boombex, he's going in for the Juggernaut as well. A spell steal comes in. X Nova, he wants to get in there. He wants to be mean, but the glaive's just bouncing around from Luna. We got two gems on deck as there's buybacks about. Warriors Gaming Unity going in onto the Luna. This could be a dieback for her. She cannot afford to get down here, but she does fall. 2 minutes without a Luna. It's seeming like this game may be slipping through Clutch Gamers' fingers right now. Although with the kill on the OD, that's equally as huge. No buyback on him either. What a back and forth hold here, but Jug Illusions finally chipped down the tier 3 in the bot lane. He's getting to work on the racks now. Right, so both teams fighting without a core, but Dire, they've still got more men in the party. Fly solo is a 4-shot from Juggernaut. Slardar now the only one alive, still 21 seconds before Disruptor's gonna be back. It's Slardar versus the world, man.
Oh, Slardar with
he got him.
No buildings versus the world. Tinker's back now.
Dude, Slardar, he's got this, I believe. He's safe, he's fine. He's fine.
Team? That's a team question mark moment, I think.
How do you even team? Everyone's dead.
That's the joke, Annie.
I'm really tired. I'm sorry. All right, Disruptor, nice little ult there, but Armel is still in some serious trouble. Tinker will be killed off, and the GG comes out immediately following. Warriors Gaming, either they got momentum from series number one, or they're just looking like a super solid team, because they annihilate Clutch Gamers after 50 minutes of hard-fought action.
Yeah, it was close to slipping away, I think, a couple times there. Just maybe not finding their earliest game push, but coming online a little bit later once they get some bigger items.